Hello students, this is Faizan Mirza. We are discussing independent assortment and the cases in which it can get changed. So independent assortment ratios, you can recall it means that there is no linkage. The genes at different loci cross over independently and end up in a gamete independent of the presence or absence of the other gene or in that case. For example, if an organism is capital A small a, capital B small b, you can expect the organism to have four kind of possible combinations of the gametes because there is no overlapping condition where the capital A and capital B might not be present together. All four of them can be present in any combination. So in this case, if purebred parents are taken and they are crossed, all the offsprings in that generation will be hybrid and they all will have the dominant features in their phenotype. Now, when you go for a sibling cross here, you cross the offsprings of FN generation together. You expect the ratio to be 9:3:3:1, where you will get three different new varieties and one and which are recombinants in the phenotype. Now, if you take the offsprings of F1 generation again, one of the F1 generation offspring, and you cross it with the recessive of its own kind, small a, small a, small d, small d, you expect the ratio to be 1:1:1:1. In this phenotypic ratio, you expect that you expected. There are four different phenotypes. There are two new varieties. Why? Because capital A small a, capital B small b, it ended up producing four type of gamete. It is in this case, there can be four kind of gametes. Capital A, capital B, small a, small b, capital A, small b, small a, capital B. If it was the case of linkage, then the red ones, which are encircled, would not be produced. A capital A would stay in a gamete with a capital B. A small a would stay with a small b. And a capital A small b and a small a capital B would not be produced. This is what we are yet to discuss. In this example, this was just an introduction of to recall what basically we expect the ratios to be. When do we get 100% offspring? When we get 9:3:3:1? When we get 1:1:1? And all these factors, they actually tell you that the genes that we are discussing, they follow independent assortment and they are not linked. Drosophila is particularly useful in studying genetic crosses. Why is that so? Because it easily mates and it produces a lot of offspring, which mature in a very short span of time, and they can be cultured and sterilized very easily. And you can temporarily put them under anesthesia, and you can observe them very well. So the wild type organism and a mutant type, what's the difference between them? Wild type is one which is very common in nature. That's called as wild type of that organism. Wild type Drosophila actually is having this kind of an antenna on its head and the thorax and the wings. You can see the wings, how the wings are pretty large here, and the abdomen with three pairs of legs. And then there's a compound eye. You don't need to learn all the details, but you need to just actually visualize how the Drosophila, this wild type looks like. There are some mutant forms of it as well, the ebony body, the vestigial wings, and the white eye mutant, and some others as well, which will come shortly. Ebony body means that the body will have these black stripes. Vestigial wings means that this organism will have these kind of short wings. So whenever the organism is having when the Drosophila is having a normal body, it would have these striped brown stripes on its body. If it's ebony will be completely black. The stripes will be there, but it will be a pretty much black phenotype. If we cross them together, so this is what we see, right? You cross a normal wings ebony body wild type with a vestigial wing ebony body mutant form. So if you cross them together, you expect a hybrid to be produced. This is what's present. It is having the phenotype of the dominant parent. The normal wings are there, the normal body is there. Although this F1 offspring is having the alleles very similar to capital A small a, capital D small d, which means it is having small the recessive alleles of vestigial wings and ebony body from this parent as well. So when you go for sibling cross of F1 generation, the F2 generation will produce in this case 9:3:3:1 ratio, very similar to the one that we discussed in the purple stem and green colored of tomato plant, and how potato and cut leaf are produced in that particular example. This is exactly the same. This the differences that we are discussing for a different organism. The idea of autosomal linkage is that the genes are located very close to each other, so they form a linkage group. They, upon crossing over, they do not assort independently. They stay together. When they stay together, what happens is you can see if the chromatids, the sister chromatids are overlapping here and forming a chiasma, capital D, capital E, small d, small e, and they cross over. So capital D is likely to take capital E together with it, and small d is likely to take small e together with it to the other chromatid when crossing over occurs. because physically capital D and capital E, small d, small e, on that chromatid are lying so close to one another that they cannot independently assort. If one is going in the opposite gamete, the other chromatid, the other will go as well. They form a linkage group. How do we denote a linkage group? This capital E is written as a capital D, capital E in brackets, and small d is written in the other brackets to denote that this is a linkage group. We do not mention them in the normal notation of capital D, capital small d, capital E, small e, in which we used to write capital D, capital E, small e. Rather than writing it that way, we mention the linked group together and the other linked group together. This is how it is mentioned. And since the genes are not sorting independently, we have to follow this kind of notation. The example that we took for initially purple stem and green color, in that we did not write it that way. We wrote it capital A, small a, capital D, small d, because the genes were assorting independently. This was not a linkage group. This is a linkage group. So here we are discussing an example of Drosophila. Again, as I discussed earlier with you, that the body color of gene in Drosophila can be capital E or small e. This is LA for striate body and small e is for ebony body. Ebony is that black thing that we discussed. Antennal shape can be either normal antenna or aristopeda antenna. Normal antenna can be capital A, capital A, small a, or aristopeda antenna could be small a, small a. This is the aristopeda antenna. And you can see how this organism differs very well from its wild type. So here what you are taking parental phenotype, a striate body, normal antenna and ebony body, aristopeda antenna. Both are purebred. Both are purebred means they both have the dominant and the recessive in the homozygous states. So this is they both are crossed together. You get 100% hybrid here, striped and normal antenna. This is the kind of cross that we always end up getting whenever we cross purebred. Whether autosomal linkage is present or it's absent, we get 100% offspring which are hybrid. Now, you went for taking the striped and normal antenna. You took the F1 offspring from here, this one, but you took the male from here. And you cross this male with a female of ebony body and aristopeda antenna. This is the recessive for both. So the linkage group of this is mentioned, the linkage group of this is mentioned. Now, since this is linkage group EA, this will go in one gamete, the small e will go in the other gamete. And since both linkage group here are the same in female ebony aristopeda antenna, it will form only one kind of gamete. So when you cross them together, the male gamete is mentioned here, the female mentioned here, you come across with the cross. You get striped and normal and ebony aristopedia. The cross shows to you that no new variety is produced. Striped normal was a feature present in this parent, and ebony aristopedia was present in this parent. So no new combination form, no recombinant form, no new varieties formed. Why? Because autosomal linkage was present in this condition. But let's take an example of females. In females, what do we see? In females, if we take striped body normal antenna, and from F1 offspring, if you would have taken striped body normal antenna female, and if you would have crossed it with the male of ebony and aristopeda, we mentioned the linkage group as well, as we mentioned. But in female, we see that the linkage group is breaking. The linkage group will form the kind of gamete that the male was forming, where the linkage group stays intact. But few gametes in the female will be produced in small numbers, where the dominant allele and the recessive will come together, very similar to a condition where we used to see that autosomal linkage was not occurring. So new variety gametes will be produced. If you cross this with this male, and what you get, this is the male gamete here, these are the female gametes mentioned here, you get these varieties. If you get these varieties, a striped normal, ebony aristopedia, both the varieties are very same to the parent. Striped normal, this is striped normal. This is ebony aristopeda, this is ebony aristopedia. So two of these organisms, they basically are getting the same kind of phenotype there with the parents. But striped and aristopedia, this is a new variety. Ebony and normal, this is a new variety as well. So these new varieties are because of these two gametes, which were formed in a small number. So in females of Drosophila, this linkage group breaks, but in the males, the linkage group doesn't break. So this is an example of this is the example of autosomal linkage. If you count the number of offspring, parental classes include the organism which did not show any linkage, in which the parental phenotype was repeated. The recombinant classes include the recombinants, the new varieties, which will be very small in number because the gametes which were having the new kind of combination where the linkage group broke is small in number. So recombinant classes, again, if you just come across, so they are produced here. But yes, the ratio is the likelihood will be 1:1:1:1. But when you try to just count them, you will see that the number, the percentage is quite different. What is crossover value? Crossover value basically means the percentage of offspring that belong to the recombinant classes. How many offsprings in that particular outcome are actually recombinants? So this is crossover value, and crossover value depends on is actually proportional to the distance between the loci. Closer the genes together, the distance between them will be shorter. So the crossover value will be shorter as well. This is the diagram showing to you how this male Ebony and Erysipelida will have the gametes with small e. This diagram is taken from Mary Jones. And the phenotypic variety of female striped and normal antenna. This is the conditions, capital E on one chromosome and small e on the other homologous partner of that chromosome. Crossing over will occur in very few of those. Most of them will not show any crossover. The gametes will have the same capital E, capital A, small e, small a, as just discussed a few minutes earlier. And then this is the condition here, the crossing over chiasma formed between these two loci, and capital E and capital A, they just switched over. So capital E and capital A ended up in one gamete, small e and small a in one gamete. So some gametes will have this kind of overlapping conditions, and this is what we just discussed here. So this is an idea of autosomal linkage. That's it for now. Thank you so much.